bank bonuses. Do the executives actually deserve the bonuses they're getting? And if they don't, is there anything we're going to do about it?
Well, I would divide the bonuses into two parts, 2008 and 2009. The idea that any of these banks, the people who work in these banks, deserve a bonus for 2008 strikes me as ludicrous. The banks failed. All the big banks failed. They had to be rescued by the taxpayer. That is just the plain, horrible facts of the matter. So on what basis? The bonuses are for performance, remember? It's performance-related bonuses. So what's the basis for a bonus for 2008? Now, as for 2009, that's a more interesting conversation. You know, they were rescued in 2008, so that's the basis of them restarting. But I don't think it's a terrible thing for anybody to be able to speculate and make a fortune. If you want to go to Vegas with your money, that's fine with me. My only problem is if you go to Vegas and you blow so much money that the taxpayer gets involved, so there's some sense that you get the upside, me and the other taxpayers get the downside, then we have to have a conversation. And I think that's what's worrying about anyone who's in this too big to fail category, anybody who's above, say, $500 billion in assets. That's the size of banks and things like banks that were rescued. If they start to pay these big bonuses encouraging risk-taking, then there's a contingent liability for the government, actually, from that, just like there's a contingent liability for the government from, say, Medicare in the future. The cost of future bailouts needs to be costed in the federal budget. That's going to be very much driven by bonuses and risk-taking in the biggest financial institutions. That has to be addressed.
Is too big to fail going to be addressed? When we've talked in the past, you've constantly identified that as perhaps the biggest problem. Anything going to happen with it?
Not really, unfortunately. So I think where we are in the debate is that there's something of a consensus that big financial institutions shouldn't get bigger. And one CEO said to me recently, the cult of size on Wall Street is finished. People used to ask him, when are you going to acquire things and become bigger? Now they don't ask that anymore. But there's not much market pressure to become smaller right now. And the government is also, the executive branch, has run into trouble because they didn't push for reforms when they had the opportunity earlier this year. Now the lobbies are back. They're very strong. The other regulators have dug in. Even the Federal Reserve and the FDIC are opposing Treasury's attempts to deal with these problems. You know, it's swimming in treacle right now, the Geithner-Obama reform proposals. It doesn't look like it's going to get very far.
Treacle? I don't think that's an American term.
Maple syrup. You're swimming in maple syrup, which I haven't tried, but I would presume would be much slower than swimming in water.